Actually talk about the bikes while I'm at them so that you have something to stare at and you're not just listening to me say a bunch of words and go, what the heck are you talking about? So it should be pretty good. I've only done this a lot, even just this week. So the Slammer line, a lot of people been around. They've done Slammer for other segments of the GT brand, brought it under the GT roof. This is what you could call the entry level for us. It's a 249 bike. But you look at it, even, you know, a couple weeks ago when we were in Europe, they built up last year's version of the Slammer at a German shop, pretty particular on how things go, and the builder was blown away when he put the price tag on the bike, because he thought he was building a high-end bike that was gonna have, you know, probably $1,000 US retail on it, and it wasn't. It was a $250 bike, and it blew his mind, and that kind of, I think, sealed the deal for us at Kunstform in Germany. And I was like, wow, if you like last year's bikes, you're gonna love this year's.
What do you think of the bike, sir?
Good. I really like them. I like the color. Blue and the black. It's like
Word.
A raw in there, too.
Word.
I really like it a lot. It's got that blue camo that looks really good, and then they got those two-piece cranks that apparently you can only get them on these bikes. And then they got the free coaster in the back that's really popular. A lot of little details, like on the seat. They got the little weather patch on the back there.
And you see a lot of bikes.
Yeah, yeah.
And so what do you think, you know, these bikes in comparison to some of the bikes you've been seeing this year so far?
So far we've seen a couple different brands premiere their 2017 bikes, and we've seen a lot of unique colors, and GT did a really good job with their color selection this year. And, you know, it's starting to get to the point where you're getting a lot of quality for your money. So even at like a low price, you're getting a really good bike. And 10 years ago, you couldn't do that. You know, 5 years ago, you couldn't even do what you're doing now. Hey, what's up? I'm Kurt Hoberger from BMXUnion.com. We're an online-based BMX magazine. You know, interviews, bike checks, videos, you name it. We got all the latest BMX stuff. And you're watching SugarCane.com.
BMX Union, pure BMX dopeness. Getting some professional photo love right here. Exotic photo taking. He's getting the flash ready. Real high end stuff going on right now.
I'm just faking the funk. I have no idea what I'm doing.
BMX fire, yo. This is Jeff Z. He's gonna make these bikes look good.
That's right.
Doing this. This is what I do.
That's right.
Making things look nice.
That's right.
Making them look sexy. See that right there? It's a silhouette on my camera, but when he gets the photos going, it's gonna look crazy with the backdrop. We're here at the GT 2017 BMX line at 5050, and we're just checking the bikes out, man. They got some nice bikes. We're loving the trend of actual colors and colorways on freestyle street bikes. That's a good thing, man. I was getting kind of sad for a while with no decals and just black flat back bikes and stuff like that, man. What do you think about that?
I like the colors too. I mean, flat black has its place in the streets, you know, it's kind of the core staple, but look at this guy, look at his shirt. I mean,
yeah, this is all about the streets right here.
You gotta have the kit, you know, if you got a shirt like this, you need the colorful bike too.
That's right.
It's all about the streets, you know.
That's right.
Your line is really colorful. Got some cool stuff going on there.
Yeah, because I think I'm staring away from the black, you know, I'm big into the streets, but I'm big into the colorful streets.
Strategically taking photos See that? Professional status right there. What do you think of the bikes you've seen today?
They look great. Some great looking stuff out there.
That's what I'm talking about. GT is putting it on for 2017. Man, where you going with that performer, man? What you doing with that? You trying to take the bike? What's going on, man? What do you think of this one?
I like that translucent purple. It looks really cool, but the donuts, the junk food seat is what they're calling it. The pizza and the donuts and everything, that looks amazing.
Yeah, and it's pretty cool that they're starting to make their signature wheels again. I mean, tires again.
Yeah, yeah, bringing back the pool tires and then the GT tires with the logo. The logo looks really good. So, yeah, it's cool because they're taking like the stuff that worked back in the day that was really popular, bringing it back with like a more modern twist, and it's great. Like, people are loving it. So from what I've heard, it's nothing but good things. So
that's awesome. That's awesome. See, we're just gonna be harassing you all day. If we see you doing something, we're just gonna come around and harass you.
I'm a product nerd, so like I'm freaking out right now just like looking at everything. I'm like, whoa, like all the little details.
Yeah. Love it. And that's another cool thing is this, for a while it seemed like people weren't really paying attention to details. Not in a way where you would notice it, but you know, after watching them talk about the bikes and the different things and some of the little nuances about the bikes, it's really cool that they're taking time about the details on the bikes.
Yeah, yeah, and it's kind of got to the point where the bikes are so good, like you can get them for a really good price, but then you gotta look at specific small details that you might not notice are what makes the bikes now. So, you know, it's the things like the graphics, or on this one, they got the hubs that kind of match the color and everything. So the teal blue. And like, it's just those small things that really can make a bike like look completely different. Like these two bikes are the same bike pretty much. Colors, graphics, it just kind of changes the whole personality of the bike. So
it brings back memories of the good old days when like all the bikes had their, you know, all these awesome colors and stuff. And I think it may be thanks to some of that retro movement, because, you know, when a lot of those bikes started coming out again, you know, they represented a lot of different colorways and things like that. It really made the bike stick out.
Yeah, and that's something I think we've been seeing kind of throughout the whole industry, is a lot of like a retro vibe, but more modern feel. So they'll be bringing the brighter colors back, and you know, like the classic, the tires, for example, like they're bringing stuff like that back, and it's, if it's not broke, don't fix it. Essentially the same thing. So yeah, it's really cool to see.
How you doing?
I'm all right. How are you?
Good, good. What's your name and what publication you're working with?
My name's Mark Noble, and I do stuff for BMX.com, which is our own website, and I'm shooting some photos for Ride as well.
Nice, nice. And what do you think of the bikes you're seeing today?
Real impressive, because I've been party to sort of prototypes and samples and how the line was shaping up with Ben anyway, because I also work for CSG. So I knew how they were coming, and I saw sort of previews ages ago, and we've seen studio photographs and so on anyway. So I was expecting good stuff, but I really wasn't expecting how good they are in the flesh. Seeing them in the flesh is a whole different thing, really. These bikes have come out awesome.
Nice, nice. And out of all the bikes, which one was like maybe your favorite looking one, or your favorite one that stuck out the most?
I'm really into Jason Phelan's bikes. I think they look really outstanding. But BK's bikes as well, they are absolutely dialed. Really into those.
And it's pretty cool that, you know, you got these completes now that are at such a crazy price point. And just the fact that they took the time to make sure the geometry and stuff looked on point, you know, was pretty cool.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, you've got to really build these bikes so kids can buy them and go straight to the park or straight to the spot and just ride straight away and not feel like they're an inferior bike at all. If they can't afford a $1,000 bike, then they're just straight onto a bike that actually looks good, rides good, lasts as well. It's got to last a long time. So I think GT have really pulled it off this time. Ben Ward's done a stand-up job on this whole line. It's really impressive. Hi, my name's Mark. I work for BMX.com as well as a few other things, as well as for CSG and GT, and you're on sugarcane.com. Back to you, Billy. See you, mate.
What's up, everybody? I'm here with Jason, aka Freeman, taking a whole bunch of pictures. Super crazy camera. And he's been checking out all the bikes today. What do you think about the bikes?
Pretty sweet, to be honest. The lineup's sick. Like, colorway on this is banging. Phelan's bikes, I don't know where they are. They're pretty crazy. And it's cool. Like, good to see that they've come full circle and like Mate, everything legit. It looks sick.
Out of all the bikes that you've seen, which one did you like the most, actually?
Kaczynski's one. Just looks like a bike. Like, you build up yourself, like, and it just comes straight like that. It's freaking sick. Bars look cool. Copy of the originals, I think. I'm from England, UK, south of England. Shooting for Endless Mag. We got it.
Endless came all the way out to check out the GTs, that's what's up.
Yeah. First time to the States, New York, good place to be.
Really? It's your first time in New York?
Yeah, it's good. Wow. Love it. Food's amazing as well. Yeah. Just like street vendors. We don't get that at home. It's
good. What do you think of 50-50?
50-50 is cool. Nice. I think I've seen this on some videos before, like old videos. And yeah, it's cool in here. Quite tight setup. Like, it's fun. It's hot. Get the fans going. Got the fans on, so it's chilling. Just chilling with the GT guys, going around with the new team. Shooting an interview with Conway, your boy over there. So this should be pretty fun. So what's up, Foo Man? I'm here for Endless Mag, shooting the GT launch at 50-50 and we're on sugarcane.com. Back to you, Billy.